In this video, you're going to learn how to build a website with multiple pages using Bolt. So this is going to be strictly a website as opposed to an app, which users log into and we have more logic. This is going to be a website. So let's get started. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to say I want to build a 5-page website for an accounting firm. So let's just enter that in, and let's see what the AI comes up with. So another way you could do it is tell them the exact 5 pages you want, but I like what it came up with: home, services, about, team, and contact. So it came up with those 5 pages, and it is just kind of building out the initial parts of the website. I'm going to pause the video, and I'll start it again once it's finished with this setup. So here we are after its first generation, and this happens sometimes. You'll see an error kind of pop up here on the preview. So what I'm going to do is just copy it if this happens to do the same thing. And I'll say, I get this error on the page. I don't see anything else. And then I'll paste it in, and then let's pause the video and see if it's able to fix it. Okay, so here we are. We have the website ready for us to preview. So we can see off the bat, it looks like it created the 5 pages that we wanted: the service, the about, the team, and the contact. So overall, I think it did a pretty good job for a first run through on this website. We didn't give it any design inspiration or anything at all. The next thing I'm going to do is work a little bit on the design. So let's give it some examples of what we'd like. So let's tell it this is a great start. I'd like to improve the design now. I want to optimize for conversion and build trust through the design. Make the website pop more and overall improve the design so it would impress someone who is a designer themselves. So just a little prompt I made up here. And let's see what it comes up with that prompt. So right off the bat, I can see that it is editing the design files. It's editing, it looks like it's adding some animations, some scrolling. Okay, so here we have the updated website, and it looks a lot better already. And I like how they added this background image. They really made this look a lot better. I like how they added these kind of trust indicators here. So they did it on the homepage, and I think they did it on the, let's see, which if I go up, I had to actually ask it for the same error issue that there was before, but it fixed it. But it said it did it on the homepage. I want to continue enhancing the about and contact pages. Okay, yeah, so I'm going to say now enhance all other pages as well. So let's let it do that. I'm going to pause and then we'll come back to the video. All right, so now let's check out the other pages. It looks like they added kind of some nice animations, some nice hover animations. Right now, we could have that go to individual pages. Right now, it's just going to the same services page. I like how they added this CTA at the bottom of all of the pages as well to schedule a consultation, which puts you through to the Contact Us page. It improved this design as well, some icons, also drop shadow. Just overall, I think just made it look better. Team, same thing, same design system, and same for About. And then we can see how it looks on mobile as well. And then it looks like it automatically created a drop down here to go to the different pages, which is really nice that it just took care of that automatically. So the next things that I would do if I were building this out more is, first of all, I would think more about exactly what I want the design to look like. If it's color scheme, if there's other websites that I like that I want to send screenshots to, you can just copy and paste screenshots into the chat and give it that as design inspiration. I would start thinking about that in order to kind of tweak the design to exactly what I want. You also, if you wanted to change the text on the page, you could just prompt it and ask it to change the text. You could either ask it to improve it in a specific way, give it specific text, or you can go into the code, go under pages, And then you can just change it directly here. So if I just wanted to change it from your trusted partner in financial success to, you know, we are the best firm to work with, something like that. And hit save on the top and we go back to preview. Now your text is updated here. So you can just go directly into the code, make those changes really easily. Something I really like about Bolt is that you can just go in and make code changes right there. The last thing I want to show you for now is how to deploy the app. So it is as simple as clicking deploy on the top right. It's going to deploy the application to Netlify. Netlify is basically a hosting solution. It's going to deploy it to this link, but you also can transfer it to your own Netlify account and then add your own custom domain. So literally in 10 minutes, we have a 5-page website. Of course, there's more that you'd want to do and tweak it and make it your own and improve it. Oops, looks like for some reason that page isn't working. Actually, that's interesting. Let's try and solve that because basically I think there's some issue on the new domain with the other pages. So let's go back. So I'm going to say on the deployed version, I can't click to other pages, only the home page works. So this is how, this is what you do. You debug, try and give as much information and be specific about the issue that you're seeing. And then I'm going to pause the video. Let's see what happens. Okay, so it says that it has fixed it, and I believe it has deployed as well. So let's open the website and see if that actually solved it. Refresh services. There we go. So now we can go to all of the pages here on the website. So pretty cool. You can think about, you know, when you might want to use something like Bolt versus something like Card or Squarespace. I think that for websites, it might be getting to the point where it might be easier and quicker to just use something like Bolt or Lovable to build out your website. You might not be able to tweak it exactly how you want because you're going to have to tell the AI what you want. But in a lot of cases, the design is going to look really good. And I think it's a really good starting place. And for a lot of people, this might be good enough for what they want. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you have any questions about it, let me know. Leave a comment below. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more content like this for free. And check out No Code MBA, the link in our description, to get a lot of in-depth content with detailed courses on how to build with AI tools, how to build with no-code tools like Flutter Flow, Bubble, Airtable, Zapier, allowing you to build fully functional and complex apps without needing to know how to code. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you in the next video.